Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a while since I've been on my channel. For those of you that don't know, I am expecting my second child and I'm basically due any minute now. So my boyfriend and I have just been kind of just anxious and waiting, and I've been in the funky mood of just not wanting to film. I'm just so uncomfortable. I'm just ready to have her. It's just the pain and the discomfort, not being able to walk, really can't do much at this point when you're so close to your due date. But today, actually, I came up with just something very soft on the eyes and easy. I kept it on the drugstore side. I try to keep it as affordable as possible. There might be a couple items that are not drugstore, like my brushes, but other than that, it's fully drugstore. There's a couple new products in here that I will be trying, and let's talk about this glow. This is only $3. You will see what I will be using in the video, but it is gorgeous. And I don't wear highlighters in the winter, but I was like, for those of you that do would like to have that glowy look all year round, I'm gonna go ahead and do it. So I like how it looks. I actually do. Maybe I should give it a try more on wearing the highlight. So yeah, so I hope you guys enjoy. I hope you guys are having a really good new year. So until next time, bye. So as you guys can see, I already did my brows and I did one eye. For my brows, I used the NYX brow pencil in Espresso. It's a little lighter for my brows, but it worked. So moving on, to prime my eyes, I just use my concealer, the Maybelline Fit Me in Sand, and then to set it, I just use the banana powder in my contouring palette from the NYX palette. So we're gonna use two brushes only for our eyes. I didn't want to use anything high brand. I wanted to stick with something affordable since this is a drugstore tutorial. So for my crease and my transition color, I'm gonna go in with my NYX contouring palette and two colors we're gonna be using from this palette. So I'm gonna go in with my e.l.f. Professional Blending Brush, and then I'm gonna pick up this color right here. It's a more cooler tone. And then we're just going to pop that in our crease. Now, sometimes I wing out a little bit my shadows, but I am going to kind of keep it more of my eye shape, so more round on the outer corner. And now, because we are only using two brushes, I'm going to pick up my Vera Mona brush cleaner. I just got this off of Amazon. This is not a drugstore. It is pretty pricey, but you can use like a paper towel or a cloth. It will do just the same job. So the reason why we're cleaning this is so that we can blend out the edges without having to put any more shadow on it. Now, this eyeshadow, I actually heard of it from a YouTuber. Her name is Melissa La Torre, and she also used this as her highlighter. So I picked it up because I felt it's only $3, less than $3. I need to try it out, and it looked really, really good on her. So we will be using this on our eyelid, and it would also be our highlighter. This is by Maybelline. It is called the Glow Down, and it looks like so. And I'm going to be using our second brush, which will be the Wet n Wild eyeshadow brush. I'm going to pick that up and place that on the eyelid. All the way to the inner corner. So now, taking that brush that we used for our transition color. I'm just going to buff out that crease a little bit. And then I'm going to pick up my NYX palette again. And for the outer corner, I'm going to take the darkest color, which is this one right here. Now, with that eyeshadow, I'm going to pick it up on the tip of my brush, tap off the axis, and press it on the outer corner. Right now, I'm just pressing in the area that I want it. Then go in again. Bringing it up towards the crease. And then I will also clean it again, just because that color is very pigmented. So in order for me to go in the crease, I don't want it to have any of that color. And it just helps me blend everything easier. And then kind of just looking at it, making sure that it's even, tipping it one more time. And then just pressing it. I'm not really going to move it this time. Just going to press it where I want that depth. And then going to pick up that eyeshadow. It's very buttery. It feels very nice. I'm just going to put that in the center. Gonna buff it out with my index finger. And then I am going to go in with my NYX eyeliner. It's in dark brown. So I'm just going to tight line my upper lash line. I didn't use black because I want this to be soft. A soft look. And then I will do my waterline as well. And then now we're going to curl our lashes using my Revlon eyelash curler. All right, and now that we curled our lashes, I used the Maybelline Lash Stiletto Waterproof Mascara. Now we're going to move on to the face. So for foundation, I'm going to be going in with the Fit Me Shine Free and Balance stick. I'm in the color 220, so natural beige. And I've used this only once. I got it about last week, but I do like that velvety feel it gives. Also, for me to prime my face, I actually just used my moisturizer by Neutrogena in Deep Moisture. It's a day cream. It feels really good on my skin. So I used that. Now, you definitely built this up. So it's medium coverage, medium to full. Now, for me to blend this out, I will be using a Sigma brush. Just because I don't have anything that will buff this out. I don't want to use a beauty sponge. When it's a cream foundation, you want to use something like this. This is the Sigma Flat Kabuki F80. Or you can also use a stippling brush. So you definitely want to take a double take. This is just one application of it. So I kind of just go into the areas I feel that I need a little bit more. That should do it for now. Now to conceal my eyes again, my Maybelline Fit Me in sand. I'm going to be using this beauty blender. I got this for Christmas as a gift. My boyfriend's mom got it for me. I think she got it at TJ Maxx, so I'm pretty sure it's really affordable because I've gotten some from there before and they're like less than $5. I like it because the tip really helps with going in the inner corner of the eyes. Also, another thing that I like to do, and I just don't really show it because it looks crazy and maybe a little disturbing for people, but it is important to get the crease on your nose. So I will like pull and then press it right in there. And now that we have finished our concealer, I'm going to get my NYC Smooth Skin Loose Face Powder. I'm just going to dip that sponge in there. Okay, then for the rest of the face, I'm going to use my Stay Rimmel loose powder. Actually, it's not really loose powder, but you get what I mean. And then I'm gonna go ahead and use my e.l.f. Kabuki brush to set the rest of my face. And I'm using this with a very light hand, because I am going to be trying a new product. So I found this new e.l.f. blush and bronzer. It's the Aqua Infused Blush and Bronzer, and mine is in the bronzed pink beige. This was $6. Elf is starting to raise the prices a little bit, like by a dollar or two. I mean, it looks like they're starting to put more effort into their makeup. So it looks like this in the front. It's really neat. It's black, but it has the blue lettering, and then it does have a mirror inside. This is from the reviews that I saw for this. It has a cream touch, but it dries into a powder feeling. So, if I can get this plastic thing off. So, this is what it looks like right here. And oh my gosh, it just feels amazing. swatch it right here, and it dries into a powder finish. And then the blush, also a nice velvety feeling, super pigmented, and it dries like a powder finish, but it's creamy when you apply it, if that makes sense. So I'm really excited to try these. Go ahead and use my e.l.f. Concealer brush. I just washed all my brushes last night, and it feels so good to use clean brushes right now while it lasts. So I'm gonna go ahead and pick it up. Okay, and then with that stipple brush, I'm going to try to blend that out. Looks harsh. So it does blend out pretty nice. You do gotta use kind of a little bit of pressure when you pick it up with your brush though, so that it picks up the amount that you need. It distributes very evenly too. I mean, a little bit definitely goes a long way. I mean, I've basically done one whole side with just what I put on my cheekbones. And then I will be using this to also contour my nose. Just a little bit. I'm gonna try to do it with an angled brush by e.l.f., a brow angle brush. So I'm gonna pick that up on the back of my hand. With my beauty blender. Guess it worked fine. Now, I don't think I'll be using the blush on this look. It's definitely very pinky. It's pretty, but it's not what I'm going for this look. So I'm going to set that contour with some bronzer. Set it, I'm gonna use my e.l.f. powder brush. Looks like that. It's the white one. I'm gonna grab my NYX palette, and I'm going to go in with the first one right here. Actually, no, I'm gonna go with the second one right there. Now, I am going to clean up the contour a little bit with my NYC loose powder. Now for my blush, I'm gonna use the Wet n Wild Mellow Wine shade. It's a very pretty like orange pink color, and it's matte. With this one, the black one, and I used this once. And it's very pigmented, so you definitely want to be careful. It just gives it that pretty sun-kissed touch. And then I'm gonna go ahead and clean up that area. And then go over the blush and the contour a little bit. I'm going to highlight. I don't highlight usually in the winter, but I did wanna give this a try. So I'm going to use. I'm going to use my Me 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 blush brush. And let's see how this goes. Oh, okay. This is definitely good for a highlight. And then tip of my nose. A little bit down the bridge. And we are definitely glowing for the winter. All right, and now we're going to curl our bottom. So now we're going to move on to the bottom lash line. I'm just going to give it a little bit of depth, nothing too crazy. With the same e.l.f. Blending brush, I'm going to pick up that first color we used for our crease. And I'm just going to go ahead and apply the mascara. I'm not really going to go in with any eyeliner. I want to keep it pretty natural at the bottom. Okay, and then once that's done, we're going to move on to the last thing, which is the lips. I have not tried this yet. This is by Maybelline in Gray Over It, and it is matte finish. It is like gray brown. Very pretty. I'm very excited. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop this on. And that completes this look. I definitely love this lip color. It's definitely something that I'm comfortable with. I love these kind of tones. So I think that this turned out pretty well. I'm still amazed by that eyeshadow. I mean, I think I'm gonna be using it for sure this year for spring and the summer. It's $3 and it gives you what a high-end highlighter would give you. So definitely try it out, guys. Maybelline the Glow Down, that's the name of it. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys liked it. I will try to come back soon with another video. Like I said, it's been a little crazy with my pregnancy and just being over it and just wanting to pop her out already. So we'll see what happens, right, in the next few days. So thanks so much, guys. Happy New Year. I hope you guys are starting off this new year great. So yeah, thanks so much for watching, guys, as always. Until next time, bye.